A pleasant good evening to you all from the Danbury Ice Arena in Hat City, USA. I'm Chris Lynch on the call tonight for the Danbury Hattricks, wrapping up their weekend series against the Elmira Mammoth. An offensively dominant display last night, 8-4, paced by another excellent game from Dustin Gesso, Luke Richards, and Johnny Ruiz pitching in as well. Gordy Bunnell with two goals. They have to contend with an Elmira Mammoth team desperate for their first victory as a franchise. They got a fantastic game out of Parker Mescal, number 13, who put up a hat trick in the second period and posted a remarkable offensive performance throughout and got more chances than just that. Plus, he also got an assist, so we got 4 points for the game. All four of them came in the second period. The hat tricks have to contend with quite a remarkable unit. And last night was Veterans Appreciation Night here at the Danbury Ice Arena. It is Movember night here in Hat City. Steve Hansen and Doug the Thug paying their visits here to the Danbury Ice Arena. Steve Hansen actually spoke to the team. Yes, he did the speech in the pregame locker room when having a chat with the Hat Tricks. Let's very quickly give you the starters for both of these teams. Elmira is rolling out the same starting unit up front. Yanni Liarakos, Mo Levac, and Stavros Soilis will be taking the forward spots. The Hat Tricks are going to counter on the front line with Gordy Bunnell, Johnny Ruiz, and Dmitry Kuznetsov. Johnny McDonald and Kyle Gonzalez are on D. The Mammoth are going to be rolling out with Troy Button and Thomas McGuire to be taking the defensive spots. And then, of course, the goaltenders. The Hat Tricks will be putting in Frankie McClendon, drawing in for the first time in a little bit. He's gotten one game so far. He started the opening night of the season before Brian Wilson got back here, and he gets the draw in net for tonight's game. Got the victory. The Hat Tricks, of course, unbeaten in regulation time. The Hat Tricks, one loss in overtime, which came in the last game of the Carolina series last weekend. Elmira, 0-8-1, looking for their first victory. In net tonight, they'll be going with Thomas Proudluck, who had a very strong second period. He came on in relief for the Mammoth in last night's game, relieving Trevor Micucci, just giving him a chance to hop out. And the Hat Tricks scored 3 goals in the first 10 minutes, not even, of the hockey game last night. The offense came out ready to roll and ready to perform. They certainly were able to impress and dominate the offensive pace. We're going to throw things down to public address announcer Dre, who has the full stylized starting lineup introductions for tonight's matchup. And by the way, the kids you see out bumping fists with the Hat Tricks from Putnam Youth Hockey.
National anthem. Playing the national anthem. from Barlow Mountain School in Richfield, Bobby the Bobcat.
The ceremonial pucks have been dropped. Steve Hansen makes his appearance here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Everybody immensely, immensely happy to have him on board with us here at the Danbury Ice Arena. And also worth noting, Steve Hansen told the guys beforehand, 6 months cancer-free. Thank God that good individuals are working to allow great people to continue living and keep on going through such things. Congratulations to Steve Hansen. Steve Carlson, the actor, plays the character Steve Hansen, but everybody just calls him Steve. He addressed the team in the locker room, told them to love this game of hockey. It's the greatest game in the world. You absolutely had better believe that every single one of the hat tricks believes and feels that. The puck is dropped. We are underway from the Danbury Ice Arena. Elmira looking to start this off. Blockered by Frankie McClendon, just out of bounds into the protective netting as some of the Putnam kids were coming up and underneath and around. Good thing it didn't hit any of the kids. So that's all nice and good. 10 seconds burned off the clock. Of course, everybody is going to stay out there. Mo Levac to take the draw against Johnny Ruiz. He won the first one, clean off the draw. Ruiz gets to this one. McDonald sends this round, wants Kuznetsov. The lines for the hat tricks, by the way. Gordy Bunnell, Johnny Ruiz, Dmitry Kuznetsov, Dustin Gesso, Luke Richards, Brendan Sheehan, Zach Pemeleon, Evan Lugo, who's wearing a different number for tonight, number 15, not 32, and Steve Leonard. Leonard draws back into the lineup. Ole Wenstrom is the extra forward for tonight's matchup. The D for the hat tricks, Johnny McDonald and Kyle Gonzalez, Xavier Abdella and Brendan Dowler, and Jared Yao and Kodiak White Duck. The White Duck Abdella pairing is currently out there on the ice. Abdella steps into one, shoots it, save made relatively straightforwardly by Proudluck. Came on in relief in last night's game and performed very, very admirable. That's a good crowd here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Doug the Thug made an appearance here tonight. The USA ball hockey team made an appearance here tonight. Dustin Gesso just trading sticks. Tripped up shot on, not there. Gesso Worth noting, Dustin Gesso, 9 goals, 9 assists for 18 points in his first 5 games of the season, has been just astonishing in his offensive productivity. Brendan Dowler, the Marbledale, Connecticut native, has to retreat, looks for some release off the boards. Dropped and charging on. Abdullah poked off his stick. Lugo, as mentioned earlier, not wearing number 32 tonight. He's wearing number 15. Parker Muscal, the big player for the Mammoth in last night's game. They got it down from at 1.4-0 down to 5-4. Couldn't quite end up pulling away with it. White dock across to Leonard. That's it free for Zach Pamaleon. Served a 1-game suspension as a result of the massive brawl. Jared Yao steps into one at the blue line. Walks it to the circle, wants to throw it across. A bunch of white jerseys are there for the Mammoth. None for the Hattricks. A nice, good, long, extended series of play for these teams. We've played the last 2 minutes basically consecutively. Yao thought he was going to hit a man. He hit a board instead. Shot save made by McClendon. That's the first shot on goal for the guests from upstate New York. McClendon out to play this one. He'll just leave it behind. This is one of a good many busy days here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Leonard hurls across, wanted it forward, turned over instead off McDonald's stick. Levac Liarakos. Levac was going to walk this down. Wants to put it on towards the circle, not there. Leonard going to feed it forward. Pamaleon walks it, cuts it towards the center. Not any more room to operate with. So the Mammoth are going to reset and keep themselves working and rolling. Gonzalez steps in and just chips this a bit deep. It is worth noting that for the first time in the league's history, there are two guys from Hawaii who are taking part in tonight's game. Zach Pamaleon, of course, did not play in last night's game. He's in the lineup tonight. He's on the left wing on the third line with Lugo and Leonard. And for the Elmira Mammoth, they're rolling out Lance Hamilton, number 23, originally from Honolulu. Pamaleon hails from Aia. I hope I pronounced that correctly. I'm not sure if I did. Dmitry Kuznetsov interrupts this one. He'll just funnel this down. Sticked and handled by Proud Luck. Looks for some place to release to as it up the left boards. Good hit thrown and flipped back in. Tries to cut through. Gesso, nice stick handling, walks in, shoots it, save made, and Proud Luck will swallow it up. A nice long extended sequence. Only 3 shots listed up on the board. 2 for Danbury, 1 for Elmira. A lot of skating, a decent amount of hitting. Dustin Gesso looks to jar the puck free. The Mammoth will spring themselves and look to run down. Dakota Seaman wanted to put it on towards the middle, not there. They have to reset in neutral territory. McClendon will stick this down and leave it for Abdullah. Looks for some room to work with. Dowler glides up the right wing and will deposit this. Wants it for Gesso. It's interrupted and taken by Chris Marate. Kodiak White Duck whiffs on this to the circle. Gesso walks it in. Backhander shot save made. Rebound is not there. And Proud Luck has stopped the Hattricks on a couple of good scoring attempts. Hattricks don't have a goal in the early going here. Which, of course, you can't just expect the Hattricks to score in the first minute or in the first couple of minutes of every game, but, you know, you can hope that. First 5 minutes of the game gone by. Liarakos has to flip this. Knocked down by White Duck on the entry. Lugo to Leonard. offsides. And a relatively easy offsides call to make. We'll get our first media timeout. We'll take it. Brief pause back in just a little bit from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hat-Tricks YouTube channel.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde across the club.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Vec with Come a couple on. Of big rights. He scores!
TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury. Stop by TK's, try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. My favorite is the Gold Rush. Check them out online at www.tksamericancafe.com. TK's Corner, one of the new additions for this season here at the Danbury Ice Arena. This is tipped at the red line, so no icing. Elmira trying to get to this puck. Gonzalez cuts underneath him and gets to it first. More room to operate with. Pamela Leon has to retreat, needs some help. Pamela Leon nearly fumbles it, gives away a great opportunity, and Frankie McClendon bails him out. Yanni Liorakos goes right on top of McClendon, and McClendon makes an excellent save. Lugo across, backhand shot, save made. Leonard had a good look. Lugo set him up well, and both goalies making excellent, excellent saves. Pamela Leon winds up, shoots it. He puts it off the end boards. Hat-Tricks will put it up to the point for Kodiak White Duck. Yao winding up, looking and wanting it. They'll put it on the end boards instead. Pamela Leon knifes under a man. Puts it up to White Duck, down to the circle. Across! Scores! No! No, it's waved off! How? How did that not go down? The puck was destined for Twine, begging, yawning to go in. What a save! My goodness, we're seeing that on the replay right now. What a ludicrous save! Thomas Proudluck makes the play of his life. Holy cow! Let's see that one more time. Across, he stretches, he's got that. How? And the officials immediately there waving it off. How? Okay, so the Hat-Tricks just have to go back to playing regular hockey after being robbed. Committed highway robbery with a glove and not a gun. Jared Yao, who just had his goal taken off the board by an amazing save. Trying to walk this on. They'll put it up to the point for Yao. Shoots it. Sent aside. Kodiak White Duck dives low. Whips this round the end boards. Nothing there for it. Jared Yao waiting for the puck to come up to him. He's there for it. Gordy Bunnell, who had two goals last night, shoots this on. Puts it off the end boards. Bunnell trying to pursue this into the opposite corner. Lance Hamilton there for it as well. Hamilton came away with it and put it back out to neutral territory. Hamilton interrupted by Ruiz and whipped on by Parker Mescal from neutral territory. Trying to jar this free. Ruiz ultimately is going to come up with it. Dmitry Kuznetsov lugging it forward. Stick underneath his arm from Lance Hamilton. Elmira's only running out nine forwards. They're rolling with an extra defenseman in order to compensate. Here come the Hat-Tricks, and a pretty straightforward and easy save compared to the ludicrous highway robbery from earlier.
You're going to meet some of those international stars like Lee Nobler and Brian.
Richards out to take the draw. He wins it cleanly. Sheehan's shot off the glass. Throws a hard check afterwards. Just to put it low. Sheehan overruns it. Thomas McGuire will get this one out. Macdet, Dowler tries to lug it forward. Across, wanted to feed Richards. Kept on. Gesso, shot save made. Follow-up shot not there. Danbury out shooting Elmira 8-2 in the first 8 minutes and change of tonight's game. McDonald absorbs a hard body check right into the Elmira bench. A bit scattershot as everybody trying to get their line changes correct. Mammoth trying to just retreat in their own end. Left around the right side. Official has to duck out of the way of that. Hamileon trying to take it away from Soilus. Mammoth getting out of their own defensive end. Going around the opposite direction. 11:05 the time remaining. This will find its way off the end boards. We're on the right side. Leonard not there for it. Lugo charging. Lugo dished to Hamileon. Wanted to feed it across. The Urakos had the right spot and got a stick and skate in the way of that second attempt. Levac runs on. Levac winds up, shot blocked aside. Jugging and looking. Vecino working. Winds up, looks for somewhere to go with it. Drop pass. Rock shot save made by McClendon. 10:31 to be played here in the first period. 0-0. The score here tonight. There have been things happening. I might be underselling that. Ruiz to take the draw with Tate Leeson. McClendon's going to stick it aside. Kuznetsov. Backhanded along, winds up, shoots it. Turns, fires, shot blocked. Kept in at the point, O'Connor shot blocked down. White Duck tries to shunt it. Yao will receive the pass from Ruiz. Kuznetsov needs a release, sneaks underneath Gordy Bunnell's stick, and that's icing. Elmira only with three shots so far on the night. One of them a dead, terrible giveaway by Zach Hamileon that they managed to cover up and not allow too much of a problem. Yao to Kuznetsov. White Duck has to retreat. Just leave it backwards for Jared Yao. Big play in this game. The absolutely ludicrous save by Proud Luck. White Duck blocks the shot sideways. Needs some help. Richards carries forward over the center ice logo. Gesso had to do some extra work to stay on sides. He did. Buck sits against the boards. Carried out. No room. Man goes down. No penalty being whistled, even though some of the fans called for it. Gesso forces it free. Sheehan, Dowler, winds on. Blast shot, not there, save made. And Proudluck has made his share of completely ludicrous saves so far tonight and his comparative share of just normal saves. We'll take a breather, hop back in a second from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. We'll be right back. Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattrick's official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. DPS Printing Solutions. They can do it all. Locally owned. Printed on paper from Connecticut trees. Frankie McClendon makes a couple of very good saves. He's the solution in net for the Hattrick's this evening. Springs it forward. Olli Wenström in alone. Walks it and scores! False alarm on the first carrot throw. And now you can hurl them. Olli Wenström played a great offensive game last night, did not come away with anything to show for it. He gets a goal out of this, gets a great offensive sequence, springs behind the net. We're going to see that. A great sequence to get behind and make that happen. A great goal. Great speed, great pass to set him up. That's his first point in the Federal Prospects Hockey League, and it is a stylish goal. Hattrick's thought they were going to be up 2-0 after Yao's shot got robbed. They're up 1-0. We have a late carrot being hurled in that Johnny Ruiz is just going to kick towards the bucket. If you're new here, this is the tradition. After the first Danbury Hattrick's goal, the fans throw carrots on the ice. Sometimes you even get carrots being thrown after Hattrick goals. Olli Wenström, the native of Gällivare, Sweden, at 6'2", 220 pounds, a very skilled hockey player, makes it 1-0 at the 11:17 mark of the opening stanza. We're waiting for the puck to be dropped so we can continue playing. Levac and Ruiz both out there to take it. Gonzalez tries to put it up towards center. Liorakos trying to tie this game up. Drop to the circle. Glove hand saved by McClendon. There's a rebound. And Elmira's on top of it. To the circle. Worked off their puck. Ruiz gets out to neutral territory. 2-on-2 with Ruiz jumping back into the play. Drop pass from Benel to Kuznetsov. Shot never got on net. Blocked in the circle by Tim O'Connell. Levac, circle, wants to backhand it towards the goal. Not there. Kuznetsov on top of it. Johnny McDonald ran over top of it. Mammoth turn it. Levac. Pivots needs some help. As a release valve winds up. Big blast. McDonald blocks the shot. Richards didn't quite get on that time with it. Wants to put it on towards the net. No room to operate with. Sits against the apron. Levac. Wants the Arakos, he's got him, wanted to center it. Didn't quite have the look for Stavros Soilis. Hattrick's gonna get this out to the offensive end. Luke Richards in pursuit. Tried to put it on towards the net, had no connection on it. Gesso, not there. Knifed underneath the man's charging stick. Jared Yao trying to whack it free, can't do so. Tate Leeson walks it in. Lance Hamilton in pursuit. Sheehan. No room there. Moscow taking a couple good whacks at it. Flown back into Elmira ice. Pellicino will settle this down. Stick comes out of Tate Leeson's hands. He feels as though that should have been called for a slashing penalty. It, of course, is not. Pellicino, glove down. Kodiak White Duck forward for Dustin Gesso. Eludes one would-be checker. White Duck the only man back for it. Abdullah, Xavier Abdullah played his first game with the Hattrick's yesterday. Slaloms through. Dropped and walked on. Abdullah off the end boards, looking to turn and go. Sandwiched hard and the smart decision to just cover up the puck and not allow anything further to take place. Puck is down. Looks and wanted the tip. Lugo had a stick on it. Venstrom at the first goal. Nearly got that to go as well. The pass set up by Xavier Abdella to spring Ole Venstrom, so he's awarded his first assist as a member of the Danbury Hattricks. Dowler up and forward. Venstrom walks on, shoots it, goes a little bit wide. Leonard, benched in yesterday's game, playing on this one here tonight. McClendon with the stop, just a backhanded around in front, no room. McDonald's just gonna let it sit, waits and waits. Leonard, no room. Levesque, lug it forward, lost the right side. Gordy Bunnell, gonna run this forward. Bunnell, lost it, has to get back. Drops it deep, Liorakos, the only man there for it. Ruiz in pursuit, throws his weight around, throws his man into the boards. Turnover, Bunnell, Ruiz, shot, save made by Proudluck, rebound, turns, second chance, just wide by Ruiz. Tried to center it, and he put it right on the awaiting stick of Levesque. Puck lobbed the opposite direction. McClendon will pass it over to Yao. Great chance for the Hattricks, trying to go up 2-0. Richards gained the blue line and got no further. Gesso trying to beat Parker Moscow to the puck, can't do so. Moscow puts it off the boards, winds up, blast on, shot into the protective netting. We have 4:17 left. We'll have our third and final media timeout of the first period. Brief pause, back to the second from the Danbury Ice Arena. Ultimate Limousine Service in Danbury is the region's premier limo service. You ever ride in a Bentley? If not, call them up. And next time you travel, go in style with Ultimate Limousine. Check them out online at ultimatelimoct.com. Hattricks up 1-0, looking to try and get themselves a bigger advantage. The Mammoth looking for the tie. Shot blocked aside by Richards. Moscow winds up, puts it, bar down, top right corner. A pristine shot. Parker Moscow, his fourth goal and fifth point of the weekend, ties the game 1-1. Frankie McClendon had a hard time seeing the puck through the forest of white jerseys in front of him, and so Danbury's gonna have to restore their lead. Leonard Venstrom and Pamaleon out there right now. Pamaleon's gonna knife this away. Araston, oh man, take himself down. Jakob Volk. Lance Hamilton gets the assist on that goal. Hattricks to the circle. Wanted it around Venstrom. Nearly there for it. Couldn't quite get on top of it. Elmira throughout the course of the season so far, a minus 36 goal differential, even at 1-1. Hard check thrown. McDonald's still down. Gonzalez thrown across. Wanted Leonard. Puts it on towards the net, not there. 3:10 the time remaining. And we've got our first tie-up. No fights, though. They dropped the mitts. They're not doing anything more than just kind of bear hugging each other. Seaman and Leonard going to be sent off to the sin bin for a little bit. They've whistled one penalty off against Leonard. Let's see what the other one is going to turn out to be. Johnny Ruiz giving a piece of his mind. Forgive me, it's Lance Hamilton who gets the assist. I think I did get that correct on the first time. For Hamilton, that's his third assist of the season and fourth point. And the hat tricks are about to go on the power play, or excuse me, about to go up on the penalty kill. It's a roughing minor being called against Leonard. That's why Johnny Ruiz was so unhappy with the officials for that. Lascaux winds up one-timer, blocked down by Gordy Bunnell. ...15% effectiveness on the power play for the visitors from Elmira. They got two power play goals last night. The hat tricks, a 77% penalty kill. All these worthy of concern on the part of the hat tricks as this will be flipped up towards the glass. Bunnell cuts his man off, tries to carry this forward, falls down, and well, the penalty is now killed off. Elmira's going to be going on the 4-on-4. Yep, it's a hooking minor being called against Parker Mescal. There's a minute 22 left to go on Leonard's penalty. So we'll have a minute and 22 seconds worth. Now the power play gets taken away for Elmira with the hooking infraction. And the hat tricks get to skate 4-on-4 for the next a minute and 10 seconds after a few seconds already burned off. Mammoth looking to carry forward. Leeson, or correction, it's not a hooking, it's a high sticking penalty. ...17:30 the time on that penalty. Now under 2 minutes to go here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Tries to cut towards the middle. Leeson denied any further advancement. Gonzalez tied up, shields it, and against the boards, McDonald. Johnny McDonald will look for some place to go with it. Gonzalez, the puck sneaks under his stick. Liorakos walks in, backhand, puts it wide. He duffs it. McClendon makes the save on the follow-up chance. Winds up, blast from the left circle, not there. And the Mammoth, a gift opportunity, and they let it go right by him. Liorakos turns it to the circle. The hat tricks fans believe that should be an offsides call against Elmira. McClendon with the save from the point. Here comes Dustin Gesso with the hat tricks now on the power play. Gesso, Kuznetsov there for it. Drops it, walks in, shoots it. That goes into the protective netting. And so we have 27 seconds remaining on the penalty time for the hat tricks. So 56 seconds left. That's the play that missed on the chance, and then the save by McClendon that you're seeing on your screen right now, and the follow-up great save opportunity. Dowler just about barely keeps that bouncing puck in. Bunnell's shot blocked before it ever gets on net. Yao will settle it. Yao winds up. Shot save made off the Dowler shot. Mattricks have been relatively ineffective on the power play. They got two big ones last night. They go 0-for-1, both teams with truncated power play opportunities. And we're now under 30 seconds to go. Dowler, one man to get around. It's Liorakos. He accomplishes that goal. Tries the self-pass off the boards, has to run it down, not there. Runs away from Mescal, 15 seconds. Bunnell keeps this on. Ruiz loses control of the puck. Mescal will flip it to neutral space. Jared Yao was robbed in spectacular fashion. Can't go any further with this. And that is that. One goal apiece after one period. The hat tricks, a couple of spectacular golden opportunities, and nothing there for it, ultimately. Brief word from some of our sponsors. Brewed right here in Connecticut and featured at the Rabbit Hole, New Haven Night Brewing Company is the beverage of choice at the Danbury Arena. Grab a cold one and party like you're in the Elm City. Stony Hill Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hat Tricks. So the goals are one apiece. We're going to keep the audio running for the intermission ceremony where the USA ball hockey teams will be coming out onto the ice. Johnny Ruiz, the captain of the Hat Tricks, is also the captain of the USA ball hockey team. Herm Sorcher, one of our directors, is also the goaltender on the USA Masters ball hockey team. We're going to kick it downstairs. Brief pause back in a little bit with more from ups here in the broadcast booth for tonight's Danbury Hat Tricks game against the Elmira Mammoth. Brief pause back in a moment.
United States men's national team, also our captain, Johnny Ruiz.
fans chant USA, USA on American soil. If you can do that, we're waiting on the Putnam Panthers now. Putnam Panthers, regular scrimmage game.
Go ahead. Thank you.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde across the club.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Levesque with Come a couple on. Of big rights.
He scores!
You want the best milkshake you ever had? You want to taste greatness? Hit the Holiday Diner on White Street and feast off their menu. It's breakfast, lunch, and dinner. with George and the crew. Check them out on White Street at the Holiday Diner. Kafala Coffee, our friends who have a new spot here on the concourse level. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee, plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Go talk to our friends at Kafala Coffee. You need a kick to boost your day. Welcome back into the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel for what has been an interesting night. The shots favor the Danbury Hattricks 11-8. The goals are even at one apiece. I can't start anywhere other than the magnificent save that Thomas Proudluck made on Jared Yao, in which everybody in the building, yours truly included, believed sincerely that that was a goal that found its way into the twine, but no, it wasn't. The Hattricks do get a goal a little bit later on in the game, so they do somewhat make up for the fact that they didn't get the initial tally to go their way. The Oli Venstrom ends up getting that tally for them. Sprung by Xavier Abdellah, it's both of their first points as members of the Danbury Hattricks. The Mammoth managed to knot this one even on just an incredible shot by Parker Mescal. So once more, the scoring in this game, the Danbury Hattricks get one goal to go their way after being robbed on one. Oli Venstrom set up and assisted by Xavier Abdellah. The secondary goal gotten for the Elmira Mammoth. Parker Mescal off a pass tap from Lance Hamilton, one of the two Hawaiian players taking part in tonight's proceedings. The other, of course, being Zach Pemeleon on the Danbury Hattrick side of things. Danbury and their home blacks will be going from right to left across your internet waves in this second period of action. The Elmira Mammoth looking for their first victory of the season. The Hattricks, the lone team in the FPHL who has not suffered defeat in regulation time this season. Quick look around the league in a little bit. We are underway for the second period, and the Hattricks win the draw cleanly and look to carry forward for a quick attack. Ruiz runs out of real estate. It's taken back by Thomas McGuire. Brendan Dowler throws a check. They put the defense pairing of Dowler and McDonald on the ice. They have really grown to love having Brendan Dowler in all situations. Kuznetsov flips it, wants Gordy Bunnell. Puck runs away, Gordy Bunnell, save made! But a delayed penalty, so the Hattricks will be going on the power play in just a moment. Johnny Ruiz walks around and scores it! You cannot stop him from scoring! You may only hope to slow them down! The Hattricks, 42 seconds into the second period, reclaim their lead. A great setup. And by the way, there was a penalty assessed as well against the Mammoth. I don't know if that just gets wiped off the board now, but there's nobody going into the box, so yeah, no penalty. We just move on and play regular old hockey with the Hattricks now in the lead 2-1. And Elmira looking for another response. Gesso hit from behind, and just when you were gonna have a penalty come off the board, and ultimately you just give another one away. It's just a rough look, to say the very least. 19:07, the time remaining here in the second period. And Tim O'Connor is going off to sit in the box for the next 2 minutes. Johnny's goal is an unassisted tally, and it's right after Gordy Bunnell managed to get behind the defense. So you go from a save and prepping for a power play to, well, now you have to do it. You have to kill off a penalty anyway, and you gave up a goal beforehand on a separate power play, but a separate penalty. Shot on, save made. Gesso looking for somewhere to go with this. It's Tim O'Connor sitting in the box for 2 minutes for interference. Oh no, it's a tripping penalty that goes against O'Connor. So the Hattricks, who had a shortened power play opportunity in the first period. Elmira had the full 2 minutes but gave it away with a penalty of their own. So this will be the first full power play opportunity. PA man Dre announcing the scoring. Great keep by Jared Yao. Drop for Kuznetsov. Gesso's open on the opposite side. Kuznetsov will keep the handle. They'll swing it. Yao for Gesso. Left all alone. Gesso looks for somewhere to go with it. Wanted to center it for Richards. Gesso, it spins away from him. Yao will put this on the half boards for Sheehan. Still handling. Richards, Kuznetsov with the keep. Down to Richards. Walks in, wants to shoot it. Blocked aside by Tyler Piekarski. Kuznetsov. Hold. They've got 33 seconds on the power play to work with. To the circle. Gesso walks in. Top side. Kuznetsov blasts it off the glass. Fortunate bounce for the Hattricks. 20 seconds of power play time left. They'll swap spots. Jared Yao runs into his own man. Circle! Save made! Holy smokes! Proudlock, another save. Tipped here, sits in front of his man, and finally covers it up. 2 seconds left on the power play, and goodness gracious. Thomas Proudlock has made a couple of fantastic saves in net. Stuff that you can look at and be extraordinarily happy with. Two seconds left to go on the power play. Ruiz, Bunnell, and Leonard out there. The Mammoth will kill off the penalty. McDonald holds, looks for some room. Johnny McDonald to Gordy Bunnell. Around, tries to backhand it on. Save made off the captain Ruiz's shot attempt. Ruiz winds up, shoots it, puts it off the glass. Bouncing puck. And the Mammoth are just trying to get it out of danger. Anthony Polisino will do the honors. Wolf pass for O'Connor a little bit too far. And the Hattricks just have to regroup. On net, blocker to side by Proudlock. Has made 18 saves on 20 shots faced. Elmira has gotten a grand total of 10 shots on goal so far. Ole Venstrom looks to turn and go. Has one goal so far tonight, had the first goal for the Hattricks in the first period. Lugo and Venstrom can't do much here. 3-on-3 to Mammoth. We'll just dump it and chase it. Yeah, it's a very fortunate bounce. Gonzalez was the first back there. McDonald holds and looks. Actually, forgive me, it's Abdella. Pamaleon turns it over. Mammoth are offside, so they can't do anything with it. Lugo, Abdella, just hurl this on net. Sits on the apron, Hattricks completely line change. Jared Yao gets a stick on it. Mammoth gain the attacking end. Brilliant diving effort by Luke Richards to break up that chance. Sheehan will drop for Richards. Turns it into a 3-on-1. Gesso, glove save by Proudlock. A goaltending clinic being put on by Proudlaw. Goodness. Proudlaw from Southgate, Michigan, came on in relief in last night's game, did very well. The Hattricks managed to kick up the offense enough in the third period to make it an 8-4 score. He has been brilliant tonight getting the start. White Duck shot on net, another save for Proudlaw. And we'll have our first media timeout of the second period. We'll take a breather, hop back in a second from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde across the block.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Vivek with a couple of big rights.
He scores!
Todd Maserati and Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati, Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice. Hattricks has played a clip from the movie Slap Shot. Of course, Steve Hansen in attendance, signing autographs, addressed the team in the pregame. Looks to try and put it on net. Yao with the diving effort to break up the centering chance. Another shot, gloved down by Kodiak. White Duck looks for the release valve, has Ruiz. Puck runs away from him. He throws his weight into Tyler Piekarski, and the Mammoth will get out of their own end. Can they do much with it? Run by Tate Leeson. Rouse wanted to put it on towards the opposite dot. No room from Mescal. Back comes Kuznetsov. Ruiz on his hip. Kuznetsov shoots it. Save made. Bounces to Zach Pamaleon. Flying in. Turns and shoots. And another glove hand save made. Proudluck has been excellent in net. No other word to regard it. They have added an assist to the second Danbury goal. It's still Johnny Ruiz's goal, but Gordy Bunnell has been awarded an assist. That's his third assist of the season. The goal, by the way, for Johnny is his seventh. He's up to 10 points on the season. Proudlock plays it behind him, looking for somewhere to go with this. There's Polisino. Wolf charging downhill. Dowler there for it. Picked off. Mammoth trying to just put this on net. Turned. They fire it off the side of the goal. At the blue line. Puck rolls away. 13:25 left to go here in the second period. Hattricks with a goal in each of the two periods. One for Elmira came in the first. Dowler controls the pass from McDonald. Puck will ream its way around. Pamaleon wants Leonard. Leonard tied up. Lugo tries to help him out. Four players now, five now, six engaged here. It'll be the original man against the boards, Leonard, who comes away with it. Kept in by Gonzalez, turns, hurls it on goal. Another clean glove hand save by Proudlock. .12:52 left to go here in the second period. The Hattricks in control shots wise, the time has gone up to 25. The shot hits the post. Nearly another great goal for Danbury. Puts it off the pipe. Gesso tries to get that. Richards sticks it down. Richards will work this one around the corner. We've tried to anyway. Four players engaged in a corner board battle. Up to the point, or up to the circle, Gonzalez. Can't do much here. Runs away from him. Abdullah to Gesso, and Gonzalez will settle it. Gesso poked off his stick. Yanni Liorakos. Danbury will get out of their own end. Pass up the left side. Gesso. Save made again. Crowd lock, and now we got some pushing and some shoving. Gesso not really liking the words from Tim O'Connor, so he trades a couple of shoves. Okay. No penalty, just a simple knock it off, boys. Quick look around the league for some scores with the other games in the FPHL tonight. Of course, this game is 2-1 in favor of the hometown Hattricks. Carolina leads Delaware 2-1. Motor City leads Binghamton 2-1. And Port Huron and Mississippi are knotted even at one apiece. To the circle, great tip by Yao into the glass to break up the downhill chance. Back come the Hattricks. Ruiz, Bunnell on the opposite side. Bunnell gets the loose puck. Ruiz will run this down in the corner up to White Duck. Wants to get to it. Ruiz, White Duck there for it. Kuznetsov winds up, shoots it, and a save that briefly handcuffed Crowd Luck, but he makes it cleanly nonetheless. Stays out there to take the, no, Lugo stay out there to take the draw. On come the Mammoth. Off the end boards, kicks off the apron. Nearly bounced over the goal, actually. McClendon has to cover this up. Loose puck, where is it? It's still underneath a couple of guys to the circle. Shovel down to the low boards. Dowler a little bit slow to get up. He is up, though. And cleared all the way into the opposite end of the rink. 11:05 left to be played here in the second period. Gonzalez there for it. Whacked out to neutral. Dropped on backwards. Lugo charging. Turns and pivots to the circle. Ole Venstrom. Puck worked off of his stick. Flooded up against the boards. Levac. No room for him to go anywhere. Levac will run down the loose puck, walks in, poked off a stick by Gonzalez, still hammering away in front of the Coca-Cola sign. Levac still working. Levac turns, tries to go between his own legs, didn't have it, and this is going to be a penalty against the Hattricks. It's Kyle Gonzalez, the Chino Hills, California native. So 2 minutes up on the board. The Hattricks are 1-for-1 on the penalty kill so far tonight. They killed off in what ended up being an abbreviated power play opportunity, because Elmira took one of their own. Walks it in front, shot blocked aside. It's a tripping minor against Gonzalez. 9:39 into the second period is the timing on that. They've killed off the first 30 of the power play. Tries the wraparound, not there. McClendon with the stop. Up top, tipped out to neutral territory. Ruiz overruns his man. Liorakos just holds and holds and holds. They'll regain the line. Liorakos shoots it. McClendon with the save, and the puck goes into the protective netting. 9:31, the time left on the second period. We'll have a media timeout. We'll take it back from the Danbury Ice Arena in just a second. You're on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. The musical stylings of in-house organist Hudson D. Tommaso. Do you want fun and food? JJ Stacks in Brookfield features burgers, wings, shakes, ice cream, and mini golf. Check out the menu and spoil yourself. Take the trip down Federal Road and stack it with our friends at JJ Stacks. 2-1 in favor of the hometown Hattricks. Danbury looking to try and limit any further opportunities on the offensive side for the Mammoth. We've gotten a couple on this power play. Good clear to the opposite end by Xavier Abdella. Proud luck. He's been excellent in net, settled and passed it up and forward. Good tip by Zach Pamaleon. Tia had to just retreat. Mammoth working with 40 seconds remaining. Shoveled out by Leonard, the Arakos, the pass across. 33 seconds of power play time left. The Arakos will walk this in, which was somewhere to go with it. Across to the circle, no more room for it. 23 seconds remaining. Circle shot save made by McClendon. And Leonard will knife this to the opposite end of the rink. Proudlock up to play it quickly. Hattricks have to regroup and defend. Save made by McClendon. Good walk in by Parker Moscow, who's got the lone Mammoth goal so far tonight. Puck off the side of the goal, centers it. Not there. And the power play has expired. The Hattricks are back to full strength. Mammoth still on the offensive prowl. They'll look for a couple of more chances. Shot save made by McClendon. And we're down to just 8 minutes left to be played in the second period. Danbury winning the period 1-0 as far as goal scoring and outshooting the Mammoth heavily in the frame. Looks to throw it out in front, not there. Sheehan got blocked by O'Connor. Ruiz gains the line off the long pass. Save made again by Proudlock. Sheehan. Cross to McDonald. Winds up, shoots it. Venstrom was on the doorstep. It got through him. Hit on Mescal. McClendon will not have to do much of anything. McDonald wants the stretch pass for Kuznetsov. Ole Venstrom. Therefore, it walks in. Dip. Kuznetsov shot. Save made. Long pass ahead. Isaiah Crawford, unable to control it, sends Yao into the boards with him. Ruiz takes a whack at it, doesn't know where the puck was, it's behind him. Under 7 to go here in the second period. A couple of good long stretches of play have kept this moving along. Ole Wenstrom, already one highlight goal, cuts around one man. Spins and looks for some reinforcements. He'll get it in the form of Dmitry Kuznetsov and now Luke Richards. Richards behind him, Kuznetsov sent down, and the Mammoth have some room to work with. Seaman up forward. Yao tracks down the loose puck. 2-1 in favor of the Danbury Hattricks here on the Hattricks YouTube channel. Federal Prospects Hockey League. I'm Chris Lynch with you for tonight's proceedings. Kodiak White Duck in pursuit. Puck bounces away from him. He'll send it around to the opposite corner boards. Yao fans on it a little bit to the circle. Walks in. Backhand save made. It goes across the open goal mouth. And play is going to be stopped. The net came off the moorings. Don't think this is going to be whistled for a penalty. This is just going to be a dead puck. Face-off won by the Hattricks. Richards has done a very good job in the face-off dot so far tonight. Gordy Bunnell gets on this. Head coach Billy McCreary has been unafraid of shuffling his lines a bit. The unit that's out there right now is they are going to get Lugo out to join the forward line. This is going to be icing. No, yep, it is icing. It's a busy night here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Our friends from the Mustache Classic here raising money because cancer is an abject, horrid nightmare that you just want to go away. You want to donate to some good people for some entertaining things. Donate to the good people at the Mustache Classic. It is indeed Movember. Flipped up to neutral territory off the Mammoth faceoff win. Abdella has to retreat. Looks for the stretch past neutral territory. They'll get it at least there. Shoveled up along the boards and dumped in against the Beach Wave sign. Dmitry Daniluk on the ice, started off the season looking to be a hat trick. He was released and ended up here with the Elmira Mammoth. Dowler across to McDonald. Puck runs away from him. Coming up on the final 5 minutes of the second period. Danbury with a goal in each of the first two periods. Elmira still looking for their first one. Feeds it out across the slot. No more room for it. Backhand off the glass. McDonald tries to settle it. Finally does. Feeds it for Pamela on. Across. Wenstrom. Shot. Save made. And the puck ran away from Pamela on the rebound. Tries to feed it ahead for Liorakos. This is an icing against Elmira. And we'll get our third media timeout of the period. We'll take it and hop back in a second from the Danbury Ice Arena. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your go-to place for a quality treat. yogurts, and toppings. It doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one. Bunnell puts it up to Kuznetsov. It hits him in the skates. The Mammoth hurl it over their own teammate. Sits on the top of the boards right where the glass is inserted there. Puck sits. Coming up on the final 4 minutes of the second period. Only one goal so far for the Hattricks. They have 27 shots for the game. It's been a phenomenal goaltending performance by Thomas Proudlock. Turns down to the circle, walks in, shoots it, puts it over the crossbar. Puck will find its way all the way back into Elmira ice. Turns it over. Kuznetsov can't get there. Drop pass, Richards. That was played back into Elmira ice. It would have been an onsides puck had Richards gotten to it. Sneaking behind the defense, but unable to do much of anything with it, was Isaiah Crawford. Gesso, who comes into tonight with 18 points in 5 games. Remember, he did not make the trip down to Carolina. Team has been held relatively in check as Richards tips that. It hits the official, actually. Sheehan had a whack at it. Dmitry Daniluk will get that one out. It's off the official. Richards will just retreat. Gesso needs some help. Richards tries to take a whack at it. Richards still hacking away. They can't gain possession. It's a good bit of work along the boards by Chris Marite to not allow any further advancement. 2:30 and change left. Great goaltending in this one for the visitors. Good goaltending for Frankie McClendon. Gesso feeds it to the circle. Sheehan fields it with his backhand, keeps possession, wants to funnel it down to the opposite end of the dasher. Lugo in pursuit. Crawford got to it first. 4 players there. Gesso and Lugo trying to jar this free. Lugo will get to it. Walks it, shoots it, save made. Nice rebound, and it's gathered up by one of Proudlock's teammates. Gesso will look to walk this one down. Lugo puts it to McDonald at the point. Winds up, looks for the flutter shot on. Not there, it's tipped aside. Down a luck. Spin off, absorb some punishment. Puck is free. Stevie Leonard can't get there. Zach Pamaleon tips the exit pass. This is going to be an icing call against Elmira. They were trying to get a change. A little bit sneakily were trying to get a change and denied the opportunity. Dakota Seaman has to go back out to his spot. A minute and 23 seconds remain to be played here in the second period. Hattricks lead 2-1, outshooting Elmira 28-13. Johnny Ruiz and Jakob Wolf on to take the faceoff. Ruiz off the draw, shoots it from his knees, save made by Proudlock. He'll get it out to neutral. Gonzalez and Abdullah gotten pretty comfortable playing with each other in the few days they've been on the team together. Kuznetsov cuts around one man, drops this deep. We have 1 minute remaining to be played. Two on two developing, now 3-on-4 for the Mammoth. Drop pass, wanted it across. The pass for Lance Hamilton a little bit too far. Puck goes across the open goal crease. Forward for Gordy Bunnell. Bunnell carries to the blue line. Looks for somewhere to go with it. He'll funnel this deep and hop out for a quick shift. Tim O'Connor wants the pass forward. Nice check thrown by Johnny McDonald. Dowler forward for Pamaleon. McDonald's still jostling. Man, this is an icing. Be honest, a little bit surprised that that is an icing. And then we got a fight, right? Johnny McDonald trading blows with Tate Leeson. Jersey coming off, still jostling, still going. These guys have a lot of stamina, and that's going to be that. Boy, howdy. Both guys wanted to go. 17 seconds left in the second. Nice blows for Leeson and McDonald. McDonald draws the approval of the fans here at the Danbury Ice Arena. He glides away. He'll go to the locker room a little bit early. No reason for him to go into the box. That's a good night here in Danbury. You get some goals. Steve Hansen and Doug the Thug are in the building. Hat tricks are leading, and you get a good, solid fight out of it. Something that the Hansen brothers would be very happy to see. Ruiz and Liracos are still up and chatting with the officials about how exactly this is going to get sorted out and scored. Just a brief recap on the scoring and how that's gone so far. Ole Wenstrom had the first goal of the evening for the hat tricks at the 11:17 mark of the first. Parker Mascal answered at the 15:50 mark of the first, assisted by Lance Hamilton. Xavier Abdella had the assist on the Danbury goal. Johnny Ruiz had the score that gave the hat tricks the lead. It was technically a delayed penalty that ended up resulting in an extra skater being on an empty net. The Araco shot, save made by McClendon right off the draw. Puck is down the opposite direction for Pamaleon. Overruns the puck. Gonna try for one more stretch. Yao will deny any further chances. They try to put it towards the net. Can't do much of anything with that. And that's it. The hat tricks take their 2-1 lead into the second period. The lone goal, Johnny Ruiz. And it came after Gordy Bunnell was denied on a breakaway chance. So, a low scoring game compared to yesterday's 12 goal effort between the two teams. We only have three so far. How disappointing. But if you're a hat tricks fan, you are certainly pleased with how well they have controlled the pace, how well they've dominated the possession, and how well they have made this, how much pressure they have put on the opposition. This has been a fun night for the Danbury Hat Tricks and their fan base. We're going to keep it here for the motions. We've got some people from USA Ball Hockey who are going to take an opportunity to try and win some prizes for the great people, and then we'll have puck drop. Brief pause back a little bit from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hat Tricks YouTube channel.
Sports car in this country. I don't want.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde across the club.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Levesque with a couple of big rights.
He scores!
The third and final period about set to begin between the Danbury Hattricks and the Elmira Mammoth. Danbury looking to stay perfect here at home. Elmira looking for the first victory in their franchise's history. They're a new expansion team, new to the league this year, and they are desperately trying to get their first victory. There's an awful lot of motivation on the Elmira side of the rink. Mammoth in their road white jerseys will be going from right to left across your internet broadcast waves for the third and final period of regulation. The Danbury Hattricks in their home blacks with the rabbit logo at center. They'll be going the opposite direction, left to right, for the third and final period of regulation time. Welcome aboard here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. I'm Chris Lynch for another night of wonderful hockey across the Federal Prospects Hockey League. Johnny McDonald goes into the penalty box, as does Tate Leeson. They both have to serve the remainder of their five-minute major infractions. A quick look around the other scores in the FPHL. Carolina leads Delaware 4-3. Motor City leads Binghamton 3-2. This game is, of course, 2-1. And Port Huron and Mississippi are tied at one apiece. Johnny Ruiz out to take the face-off against Mo Levac. The puck is dropped. We're underway for the third period between the Hattricks and the Mammoth. And immediately Ruiz winds up, shoots it, and puts it right over the crossbar with some heat on it. That didn't take very long to get up and running. That's a good shot. That's a good look and a good ripper. They keep everybody out there the same. Ruiz and Levac are going to take another draw against each other. Only 11 seconds burned off the clock. Ruiz wins another faceoff. Winds up, Lassett blocked aside. Carrying on out into neutral territory is Soilus. And into the Hattrick attacking end. He can't do anything with it. Gordy Bunnell will lug it the opposite way. Across to Abdullah. Xavier Abdullah needs some room. Tries to chase his own self-pass. Took a poke at it. A relatively slower game compared to the 12-goal effort between the two teams that we saw yesterday. Hattricks are on the road for a good long while after this. They don't return home until the 26th. Nice catch, as though goaltender Thomas Proudlock is a defensive back. So after this, the Hattricks are going on the road to play Motor City at the Big Boy Arena. up in Michigan on the 18th and 19th next weekend. 7:30 puck drop Friday, 7 p.m. puck drop on the Saturday. They'll then go and play Binghamton the Wednesday right before Thanksgiving. Then they'll go play these guys in Elmira at First Arena, and they come home to play against Carolina November the 26th. Comes out, shot on, save made. Dowler looking for somewhere to go with this. Dowler, and try and muscle this on. Brendan Dowler glides and will just leave it. Taken down, no penalty call. The fans believe there should have been one. The official's word on this is gospel, though. Sheehan tumbles down. Gesso ends up taking the puck away. Center shot, score! Evan Lugo! Off the nifty feed from Dustin Gesso! And the hat tricks lead 3-1, a minute and 47 seconds into the third period. Just a simple little nifty setup. Lugo knocks it home. Fans let their opinion of the Elmira defense be known. Mammoth trying to get themselves back into the game. Just a simple little nifty play. Lugo not wearing his normal uniform number. Maybe he should stick with number 15. He got a goal wearing it. Lofted. Poked aside by White Duck. For Gesso, this is assist number 10 in his sixth game played. Shot on, save made by McClendon. Brendan Sheehan gets an assist as well. That's his fourth assist and sixth point. For Lugo, it is his fourth goal in his fifth game. He's up to 7 points in the early going of the 22-23 FPHL season. A real good, solid player and a local guy from Sandy Hook, Connecticut. Sprinting ahead is Isaiah Crawford, trying to get this from Gordy Bunnell. Bunnell will win the race and win the physicality tie-up. Jared Yao behind Johnny Ruiz. He has to wait for it. Across to Bunnell. Great self-pass. Cuts around. Gordy Bunnell. Save made by Proudlock. And the puck trickles away. Abdella will center it. And just dump it. They'll hop off for a line change. Mammoth gathering their own end, looking for some room to work with. Long pass ahead. This is sitting on the apron. This will be icing against the visitors. Been a busy night. Been a busy weekend. It was Veterans Day yesterday. Of course, you remember why November 11th is so significant. The original purpose of it was the end of the First World War, the at the time greatest war ever fought in all human history. And it turned into, in both the United States and I believe up in Canada, a particularly poignant day for all to honor those who served in the armed forces. Tonight, some hockey royalty showed up. Steve Hansen came in. And in character with the jersey, with the Chiefs jersey and with the glasses, went into the locker room. You can actually see it on the Danbury Hattricks official Instagram and Twitter accounts and Facebook page. Just be aware of the other mild swearing. So, you know, if you have kids, mild swearing attached to it as well. It's good stuff from Steve Hansen, in which he informed the players. He believes that hockey is the greatest game in the world. They certainly believe so. They wouldn't be playing it if not, as the puck squirts across the open goal mouth. And Steve Hansen was fighting cancer very recently. And he was just recently, only about 6 months ago, deemed as cancer-free. And asked for prayers and support as that puck just goes outside of the post. Gesso will knock that down. Ruiz out there with Kuznetsov. It's a slightly different look on the line. Steve Hansen certainly grateful for all the support that he's gotten from all different sorts of people. Told everyone to be grateful for the game as the puck flutters into the stands. Certainly a lot for all these players to be grateful for. There's great hockey to enjoy. And they get to be a part of a fabulous sport in a great spot. He's here with Doug the Thug and also some folks from the Movember, from the Mustache Classic, raising money for Movember. Great cause. If you're looking for some place that you can be a bit generous, talk to the Movember people. Hattricks looking for more offense. Pamaleon drops it. They'll clear that out to neutral territory. White Duck funnels this one a little bit further forward. Gonzalez hands it down from the red line, smacks this on. Mammoth down by 2 goals. They trailed yesterday 4-0 and then 5-1. They were able to cut into it. They made it 4-2. Then from 5-2, they made it 5-4. Lugo, no, no, Pamaleon ran out of real estate. Liorakos forward. Richards and Liorakos combined. No room there for it. Holds it. Puck goes a little bit long. Nice long stretch of play here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Gesso. Dowler. Trying to get it out to neutral territory. Mission accomplished. Gesso still pursuing. Abdella. Carries wants. Richards there for it. The puck runs away from him. Gesso. Gathered and lofted. White Duck, the puck eats him up. Shoves his man off it. Yao, Sheehan. Ruiz running headlong. Cuts it around. Sheehan dishes to Gesso for the shot save made by Proudlock. Matrix get one shot out of it. And they have to go back and defend. 13:20 the time remaining. Jared Yao. Bats this along. Sheehan, 2-on-2 with Ruiz. Johnny Ruiz lugs this forward. Carries backhanded pass to Sheehan. Gesso with him. Carries behind the net, up to Ruiz. Bouncing puck, couldn't do anything with it. Couldn't set up for a one-timer. Abdella will send this behind the net. Runs around the dasher. Mammoth will get out of their own end. And feels like we're playing more passing drills here than anything else. No icing. Frankie McClendon thought it was going to be so. It isn't. Gonzalez, Leonard, dishes across for Ole Wenström. Whiffs on the shot attempt at the first goal of the game. Set up by Xavier Abdella. It's a very nice breakaway that got him the goal. Abdella with the keep at the blue line. Wenström, the goal line extended. Leonard wanted to put it on the stick of Kyle Gonzalez. He put it into Danbury territory instead. Gonzalez to Leonard. Wenström walks this onto the circle, tries to backhand it in front. It goes behind the net. 12:05 to be played in the third period. 3-1, Danbury in the lead. Trying to stay perfect here at home across their first 6 games. The only game they didn't win in regulation, an overtime winner against Binghamton. Backhanded on net. Save made by Proudlock and a relatively straightforward save. We'll take a breather from the Danbury Ice Arena. Brief pause back in a little bit from Hat City, USA.
Right off the jump, we've got ourselves a line ball. Robert Hyde drops the puck.
We're going to have a fight at center.
Levesque with Come a couple on. Of big rights.
He scores!
The Amber Room is an award-winning premier catering venue located in the rolling hills of Western Connecticut. For your next event, think Amber Room and make it a night to remember. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting. residence and commercial, plus of other services, including storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy. We're grateful to our friends who can put us on the airwaves and help make the Danbury Hat Tricks a wonderful member of the Danbury community and the hub of Hat City. Xavier Abdullah has to retreat, uses the net as a shield, takes the hit, has McDonald with him. Gordy Bunnell will settle it. Bunnell has an assist tonight. Richards ran into the boards, no more room for him to work with. Settled and walks in. Worked off the puck is Liorakos. Danbury plays it back to their own end. Kuznetsov dips around one man, glides on to the circle, spins and looks. Kuznetsov. Richards leaves it. Stevie Leonard walks, looks, wants White Duck, settles it, winds up, shoots it, handcuffs the goalie, but still a save for Proudlock. 3-1 the advantage for the Hat Tricks. Shots favor Danbury 39-16. Puck is down. Puck sits along the, right in front of the bench, Jared Yao. Getting all the way back to the first period. His, what would have been his first goal, got denied. Lugs this forward across the blue line. Drop pass, Mescal has the lone Elmira goal. Sent into the corner boards. Four players engaged in the possession battle. Lugo can't get the turnover. McClendon with the save on the backhander by Mescal. Gesso lugs this forward. Wants it for Pamaleon. Puck runs away from him. Nice check thrown against Pierkarski. 10 minutes on the dot left to be played. The weekend finale for the Danbury Hat Tricks. Brendan Dowler forward. His pass is tipped. Sheehan tries to flip it back towards center. Venstrom was there, got in his way. On come the Mammoth. Crawford sent down. Gesso dumps it to Dowler. Brendan Dowler dishes across. Sheehan winds up, shoots it off the end boards. Not quite there. .9:15 the time remaining. Dowler in pursuit of the puck. Flipped backwards by Sheehan. Johnny McDonald has gotten into the game's only fight. Ole Venstrom centers, walks in, dips around. Sheehan scores! Brenton Sheehan, top corner, 4-1 hat trick. As they go through the celebration line, we'll get a look at the goal. Here it is. Great solo effort, dips around one man, and a beautiful top left corner. There's really not that much you can ask out of your goaltender more than that one. Brendan Sheehan has an assist in this game. It is a 2-point effort for Sheehan this evening. Kuznetsov bumps into Liorakos. Abdullah has to retreat on the flipped puck deep. Gonzalez there for it. 8:30 left to go. Four goal effort here would be the lowest scoring game of the season here at home for the Hat Tricks. Had one game in Carolina where they got only one goal for all of regulation and the overtime that was played before the Thunderbirds got the overtime winner.
Danbury goals, scored by 27.
Jim Cerny would say. He's not here tonight, but he would make the note consistently. Bank as many points as you can here at home in the Hattricks. One of the best home teams in any level of minor league hockey and professional hockey anywhere. Lugo with the dip. Hamileon couldn't get around. Leonard pivots. Looks to put this on towards the net. Lugo settles it. Spins off his man. Settled, dropped for Hamileon. Up to the point for Kodiak White Duck. Wind up, blast it, not there. Mammoth coming right downhill. Denied the initial clean break. Walks in, wants to center it. What a save by Frankie McClendon, and he covers up the puck. Brilliant save to deny a goal for Lance Hamilton. Frankie McClendon up and enjoying himself and happy to make that save. Got immediate timeout. We'll hop out and take a quick breather here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. Back in just a moment from the Danbury Ice Arena. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Stop by and give them a visit on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can help you get there. Final 7 minutes of the weekend series for the Hattricks. Last home game for a while. Kuznetsov, no room to go anywhere. Ruiz prevents the entry. Ruiz walks this one backwards. Winds up from the point. Dowler will settle this down. Funneled in. 6:35 the time remaining. Forty shots on net. 36 saves for Proudlock. He's been excellent. Truly, truly excellent in net. Elmira in danger of falling to 0-9-1 across their first 10 games of the season. They will have gotten 1 point out of their first 10, but you know, there's something here that you can absolutely work with. Head coach Glenn Tamaris has plenty that he can work with. They have to fill out the lower parts of the roster and fill out the depth. It's a very top-heavy team. The top line, Levac, Lirakos, and Moscow, that's a good top unit. The head of the rotation is quite strong. The lower portions are a bit weaker. So they'll have to fill that out and improve the full unit as best as they possibly can. They definitely have some stuff to put together a good organization. Elmira's a good hockey market. Danbury, well, they were expecting to compete at the top of the Empire Division and the top of the FPHL. And so far, so good. Jared Yao will give this on back to White Duck. Kodiak White Duck forward for Lugo's got one of the goals for the Hattricks this evening. Wants the stretch pass. White Duck accidentally blocked that one down, turned it almost into a shot block situation. We're playing this so straight that this is ending up as being a nice, good, long time. It'll turn into an icing. Nope. Jared Yao will just have to play this one. Drop pass to an Elmira stick. Mammoth looking for something to get themselves back into the game. Down three. Shot well across. Hamileon trying to throw on the afterjets. Can't get there in time. Tipped aside. Wolf runs it in. Wolf tied up by Stevie Leonard. Wolf still comes away with it. Ferocious player, that Wolf. Isaiah Crawford can't do much here. Leonard, two on two the other way. Leonard with Pamaleon, who's tied up. In front, Pamaleon. Oh, nearly deked him out to put the puck home. Tried to pull the Peter Forsberg move. Crawford. Dmitry Danilov, his shot is blocked by Dowler. These two guys went into training camp together. Danilov and ended up in Elmira. Richards can't make a tip on this. The Mammoth are there for it to settle it down. Gains the line, turns, drops it to the circle. Pass runs a little bit away from them. Up to the point, winds up, shoots it, tipped aside by Dowler. Brandon Dowler wants the headlong pass for Ole Wenstrom. Icing waved off. Dowler, or Wenstrom actually clips the goaltender on his way through. This is a fast-moving third period. Yeah, with a couple of whacks at it. Kuznetsov glides his way forward. We'll just dump this deep. Ole Wenstrom's going to hop off for a line change. Been consistent end-to-end play. Knocked down by Gordy Bunnell. Cross to Sheehan. Bunnell holds and looks. Sheehan's going to put this one up top for Kodiak White Duck. Danbury looking for one more tally. Goalie's down. He's back up now. Poked at by Sheehan. Skied almost fully into the rafters. Mescal walks this on. Mescal shoved off the puck. Four goals in the two games. Three of them yesterday. Johnny Ruiz can't go forward. Wanted to center it. Ruiz off the Sheehan pass. Odd bounce. Helps out Elmira ultimately. They'll get it to neutral territory. Coming up on the final 2 minutes and change of this game. An extended period of play. Lugo will run this on. Lugo dips around. Lugo drop pass to Pamaleon. Shoots it. Blocked aside. Lugo wants Pamaleon. Not a big guy, but working against a couple of guys a bit taller and a bit heavier than him, but holds his own. We're now under 2 minutes to play. There is going to be one final media timeout before the last couple of sequences, which we finally get. And now we can catch our breath ahead of the final 1:42 here at the Danbury Ice Arena. Brief pause back in a little bit from the Danbury Ice Arena here on the Danbury Hattricks YouTube channel. Dowler Garage in New Preston, specializing in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike at Dowler Garage. Danbury Hattricks looking to close out a perfect weekend series. Only a minute and 20 seconds away from doing so. Kuznetsov will funnel this along. Sits against the boards here. Last minute.
1 minute left in the third
period. 1 minute. Elmira just looking for one more spark of offense. Funnel along. They got four goals in last night's effort. Frankie McClendon has faced 17 shots in net tonight, has stopped 16 of them. Tries to poke this free. the goal line extended. Winds up, shoots it. Settled down, walks it into the slot. Poked aside by Dustin Gesso. Gesso will carry this out to the opposite end of the rink. Gesso cuts his way around. Carries on to the circle. Moves through. Not more room to work with. Final 10 seconds. Elmira will just dump this down. And the Danbury Hattricks continue their impressive start to the 22-23 hockey season. 4-1 the final. Frankie McClendon gets the win in net. The Danbury Hattricks emerge 7-0-1 across their first 8 games of the season. Brendan Sheehan leads the way with 2 points, a goal, and an assist. Evan Lugo, Johnny Ruiz, and Oli Venstrom, the other players who get goals in this hockey game tonight. A fun, entertaining matchup. Good hockey played here at the Danbury Ice Arena. The Hattricks emerge with an excellent weekend performance. Danbury gathers around the Litchfield Distillery's barrel. They'll spin it a couple of times for more good enjoyment for all of the fans. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the famous early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab it at the rabbit hole and hoist the barrel with the hat tricks, as they have just done. We'll announce the 3 stars. I'll give them to you right now. Oli Venstrom, the number 3 star, scored the game's first goal. Evan Lugo got one as well. And Brendan Sheehan leads the way with 2 points on the game tonight. A 4-1 final for the Danbury Hattricks. Elmira, now they drop to 0-9-1 across the first 10 games of their franchise's existence. They'll keep working at this. They do have some real talent to work with. Parker Mescal with 4 goals across the course of the weekend. Elmira's on the road for their next game. They're playing a home-and-home next weekend against relatively nearby Watertown. November 18th, the Friday, they will be at Watertown, at the Watertown Arena, to play the defending Commissioner's Cup champions. They return home on November 19th. Oli Venstrom coming out to give his waves to the fans. Evan Lugo, the second star here tonight. Each of these guys got a goal. And Brendan Sheehan, the number 1 star. Danbury is on the road for a good bit after this. The Hattricks are in Motor City next weekend, Friday at 7:30, Saturday at 7. Then they're at Binghamton on the 23rd, at Elmira on the 25th. The next day, the 26th, they're back here at home to face the Carolina Thunderbirds. Another fitting, they face a bird team right around Thanksgiving time. So, a wonderful start to the season for the Danbury Hattricks. A dominant performance through the first 8 games of their season. 7-0-1 are the Hattricks. We'll see you next here on November the 26th when the Hattricks return home to face the Carolina Thunderbirds. For everybody with the Danbury Hattricks organization, I'm Chris Lynch. We hope you have enjoyed your time with us this evening.